He's live now at the scene where cleanup has begun. Hi, Craig.
Hey, Wendy, they have already made a lot of progress. This railing right here was gone. They've already repaired it. The roof above me has been repaired. And all of this area yesterday was covered in debris. A lot of the cars damaged. And some of the residents we spoke to were reflecting back on when the storm hit. And one of them has some video of the storm right after it passes.
I think I got a cloud forming here just south of
520. I move pretty fast.
The birds tried to move pretty fast, too, but they were caught in the tornado's strong winds, being tossed around like debris. What's tossed around now is what's left of a condominium roof. Chopper 2 video shows how the tornado lifted up a nearby roof and slammed it into another building.
He actually saw the roof lift off and come sailing across the road.
This is the road they're talking about. The roof completely flew over it, struck this building, and then landed on the other side.
And all of a sudden, he came running back in. He was going to try to close our door. And I said, no, get in the shower. And I remember standing in the shower frozen.
16 units were affected, cars destroyed, and the cleanup is well underway.
The storm hit. There were 6 to 8 people that were displaced. Now they are getting everybody back in. There are some inspectors here, some insurance adjusters, and they say they don't know just how much this storm cost just yet. We're live in Cocoa Beach, Brevard County. Craig Lucy, WESH 2 News.
Thanks, Craig. You can keep it here on WESH 2 News and WESH.